Hi, it's Alan from Crashtest Security. In this video, I will tell you more about the Heartbleed bug and how to prevent it. So let's get started. The Heartbleed bug was publicly announced in 2014 as a significant security flaw in the encryption software OpenSSL. Security experts have rated it as one of the most critical cybersecurity vulnerabilities in the last decade. It affected companies and services like Google, Yahoo, Dropbox, Netflix, Facebook, Amazon Web Services, Tumblr, and Intuit. The reason for taking the Heartbleed vulnerability seriously is because it has been easy to exploit. The exposure has been around for a long time, and spotting the attacks has been tricky. The bug affects SSL TLS protocols for secure communications and privacy for a wide range of online services, including web, email, and instant messaging. It tricks web servers into transmitting data stored in their memory, exposing various types of sensitive personal information and content. The Heartbleed bug is classified within the common vulnerabilities and exposures of the standard for information security vulnerability names maintained by MITRE SCV 2014-160. It's a buffer overread, a case when a system allows data access that should be restricted. What's the Heartbleed vulnerability in a nutshell? It allows attackers to steal the private key of a server certificate. If the server version is vulnerable to Heartbleed, cybercriminals can retrieve the private key and impersonate the server. The consequences can be dire, as secure connections to the server are not possible anymore, and confidential information can be easily exposed. The mechanism behind the Heartbleed vulnerability is, in fact, not very complex. However, it entails exploiting improper input validation in the Heartbeat extension. The SSL standard has an option to send a heartbeat. A computer can send a message to the other end of the connection to check if the other computer is online by getting a beat back. Attackers can use the heartbeat request functionality to send a malicious message instead of a regular one. This can make the computer on the receiving end accept and transmit confidential data, including the server's memory. By exploiting the heartbeat option and the lack of a proper bounds check, attackers can access the secret keys that encrypt personal data, such as names and passwords and the transferred content. The leakages include primary and secondary key material, actual content, and collateral. Primary vital materials are the encryption keys, which would allow traffic decryption, while secondary key material means credentials like usernames and passwords. Content can include emails, instant messages, documents, social security numbers, medical records, and financial details. As for collateral, it can span technical details like security mechanisms and memory addresses. In turn, this data can be used by malicious users for eavesdropping, user impersonation, and data theft. The worst part is that no traces are left during the attack, and it's executed without credentials. This makes it challenging to tackle the actual security instructions that may have occurred. The Heartbleed security hole is not considered a design flaw in SSL TLS protocol. Instead, it's a programming error in the implementation that affects the OpenSSL cryptographic library, which provides SSL TLS encryption to applications and services. The Heartbleed bug was brought to public awareness on April 7, 2014. The same day, OpenSSL released a fixed version that addresses the vulnerability. Discovery of the bug. The vulnerability was identified independently by two parties, by a Codenomican security engineering team consisting of Riku, Antti, and Madi, and by Neil Mehta from Google Security, who was the one to report it to the OpenSSL team. The Codenomican security research team discovered the giant security bug during their efforts to boost the safeguard feature of their Defensix security testing platform. They reported it to the Finnish Transport and Communications Agency to inform OpenSSL. But that already happened in the meantime. An engineer from the Finnish cybersecurity company Synapse's Software Integrity Group named the bug Heartbleed and created a dedicated website to inform the public. How the bug occurred. OpenSSL is one of the best-known SSL implementations, which enables systems to communicate with SSL encryption technology. The open source project has been around since 1998 and has gained massive popularity. It is mainly developed by volunteers, with a minimum of permanent active developers on board who review the contributions of the developers' community to the project. The 31-year-old German developer Robin Segelman added the faulty heartbeat feature, lacking a validation process of a variable containing length, to an experimental version of OpenSSL in late 2011. Then his feature's submission passed through an OpenSSL review, but the developer there also didn't catch the flawed code. The vulnerable versions of OpenSSL have been around for more than 2 years, since March 2012, before the bug was discovered and announced. Therefore, systems running earlier versions of OpenSSL were not vulnerable. In 2014, two other significant flaws in SSL were discovered in Apple's SSL implementation, and another use by open-source operating systems. Impact. The impact of the Heartbleed bug has been widespread and is thus considered critical. The consumer sites using OpenSSL display a lock icon next to the address and an S in the web address. It signifies the website encrypts and protects private data. As of April 2014, the open-source web servers Apache and Nix, which use OpenSSL, made up 2/3 of the market share of all active sites online. This gives an idea of the massive scope of the Heartbleed vulnerability. It affected digital companies and public bodies like the Canada Revenue Agency. Since attacks leave no traces in the logs, intrusion detection and estimation of the actual exploitation attempts and successes of the Heartbleed bug are difficult. Users are furthermore users able to take specific protective actions since the problem was with vulnerable servers. First, however, users needed to install updates and change passwords to ensure their credentials wouldn't be stolen whenever the bug was fixed in a system. Post-discovery actions. As a result of this critical bug, digital companies and the internet community took immediate steps to address similar vulnerabilities. Fundraising started via the Core Infrastructure Initiative by the nonprofit Linux Foundation. The goal of the funds was to support widely used open-source software like OpenSSL, which had no financing. Some of the contributors included Amazon, Microsoft, Google, and Facebook. Follow this guide to prevent the Heartbleed attack. OpenSSL. Update OpenSSL to the latest version. The following versions are known to have fixed the Heartbleed vulnerability. OpenSSL 1.0.1G. OpenSSL 1.0.0 not affected. OpenSSL 0.98 not affected. For example, run the code shown in the video. This step is key because the risk of attacks remains if you're running vulnerable versions of OpenSSL. Do you want to check the security of your web app or API? Then, try Crashtest Security's vulnerability testing software today to spot cybersecurity vulnerabilities in no time and to discover how it integrates into your development stack for efficient, automated vulnerability scanning. The trial is free. Also, subscribe to the Crashtest Security Channel to get more information about the most significant web security threats, their prevention, and how to use the Crashtest Security Suite. Thank you for watching, and see you in our next video.